Does the loss of Black lives matter when the assailants also happen to be Black? Unfortunately, I do not have a good answer for that. And tonight we're going to talk about that. Once again, it's your boy Tim, the handsome liberal. Tonight we got another somber video for you. I'm not exactly happy to bring this one to you, but yeah, there's a lot of hypocrisy going around, and this is one I just really wanted to point out. So we're going to be talking about an officer, which we kind of do on this channel, but generally when we're speaking about police officers, it's usually holding them accountable for something they've done wrong, particularly to minorities. But this is going to be just the opposite. So this is going to be in regards to Baltimore officer Keona Holley. She's been on the force for a couple years. She is a mother of four, and I'm gonna roll this clip and we'll come back and talk about it.
Rick and Vic, someone shot into Officer Holley's patrol car. She accelerated and crashed, and right now she remains in intensive care here at Shock Trauma. Police are making progress on leads in this case, and tonight we heard a powerful and emotional message from the officer's sister.
The person who did this to my sister, you are a coward.
Definitely a cowardly act, as a sister has stated there. They ambushed her in the car while she was sitting down and shot her multiple times in the back as she was trying to get away. So clearly this was an ambush, an attempt on her life. Currently she's in life support. Now, in the video is a little bit dated. They have since located and charged the two shooters who have been charged with attempted murder of an officer, as you can see pictured here. Now, as you see, they're African American. There's no outcry. You're not hearing from Black Lives Matter. There's not going to be any protest or anything. Now, had Keona Holley jumped out and shot a Black man, particularly if she was white, this would be all over the place. This story is not getting a lot of national attention, folks. And the reason I'm bringing it up is because we often say that we need more police in our areas that look like us, that maybe have grown up with us, that can relate to us. That's Keona Holley. Why the hell would you take out somebody like that? I mean, Baltimore was a hot spot with Freddie Gray. There was riots there not long ago, as some of you guys may recall. And yeah, here's a woman that is working overtime, trying actually volunteer for an additional shift to get some overtime for the holiday season. A mother of four. And some shit like this happens, and yeah, it's not getting much attention, which is why I asked the question in the beginning of the video. You know, when it's a Black person doing something like this, why doesn't it get attention? I mean, after all, Black Lives Matter, right? She's Keona Holley. Obviously, Officer Holley actually is a Black life. Does it really matter that the killers were Black? So we just need to not be so hypocritical about this, because this is the kind of shit that hurts the movement, folks. If you support Black Lives Matter, or you support the movement, or you do believe that there is a true racial issue involved with Black people, you can't turn a blind eye when the assailant is also Black. And these two gentlemen, 31, 32 years of age, both of them are very similar to the other stories I did on Daryl Brooks and the Waukesha racists and some of these other folks. These are two individuals that should have been in prison already. Long-time felons, multiple jurisdictions, you know, carrying a weapon by already a felon. They both had weapons on them and they're felons. I mean, it's a laundry list of shit that makes you ask the same question. Why are these people out? Why are they walking around when they have... These are not nonviolent criminals. This is not somebody who was, you know, had a drug addiction and you decided to let them go because you thought the sentence was too harsh. These are violent criminals before this act. So I just have to ask the question, when something happens to us, why don't we speak up unless the individual doing it is white? It just, to some degree, it actually looks racist to do that. It says, if I don't mind a Black person hurting me, but if a white person does it, I'm pissed off. Yeah, that kind of looks racist. But I want you to hear a little something from the sister. I just thought this was really interesting because this also plays into the hypocrisy. So I'm going to roll this clip because it plays into the hypocrisy.
Lifelong goal of my sister to serve the Baltimore City Police Department. If you had honest, decent, empathetic bone in your body. That you speak up and say something.
Now, as you heard her say, if you guys know anything, speak up. Now, obviously, like I said earlier in the video, the two individuals that are involved in this have been caught and charged, and they did confess. But you notice she pointed out something else. She's alluding to the fact that when things happen in our neighborhood, we don't tend to speak up. We have a no snitching clause, even though it's our neighborhoods that are being fucked up as a result of it. You know, if you would turn some of these people in a little bit sooner, maybe this stuff wouldn't get to be as bad. Now, I know I'm not going to play Superman and pretend that it's you can just walk up and snitch on a, you know, one of the worst criminals in the neighborhood and there's no repercussions. But there are ways of doing things anonymously, and there are options as opposed to just turning a blind eye while somebody destroys your neighborhood. And yeah, what she's speaking on is a real truth that in our neighborhoods, we don't tend to do shit when we're watching shit take place. It's kind of one of those, if you see something, say something. But unfortunately, in our neighborhoods, oftentimes we don't say anything. And that allows the problems to fester. You know, at the time, he's not doing nothing to me. So I'm going to turn it, hey, well, you might be next. So that's another big problem. But just wanted to run this video real quick by you guys because I think it's a real hypocrisy. And I think that it really hurts the movement by doing nothing. Now, these two gentlemen that I showed you, they went on that same night after trying to kill Officer Holley. They went on and killed another individual, another 27-year-old person. Guess most likely the race of the individual that they did kill, another black person. So, yeah, the hypocrisy is off the chain. You know, there's no Sharpton, there's no Jackson. Nobody's coming to protest or hope, you know, there may be some vigils, but it's not getting national attention. And this is what we need to stop. I mean, I'm just going to say that it has a huge benefit to us when you can have officers that are from the community, that can communicate better with the community and know lots of people in the community. So when you get something like that, you don't fucking try to kill them. So I just wanted to drop this video because I'm kind of angry on it. Once again, same shit. Subscribe to the channel if you like talking about politics and all things current events, which we do on this channel. End of the video, feel free to give it a thumbs up. Once again, this is one of those videos I expect to get thumbs down because there's nothing good here, folks. This is upsetting. It's upsetting. And yeah, it just shows a lot more hypocrisy among our community that we don't seem to give a shit when we're being killed by other people that look like us. It's just ridiculous. Anyway, your boy Tim, the Handsome Liberal, I will catch you in the next video.